In this video, we will solve some question about auxiliary equation which have complex conjugate root. This is important, not difficult, but quite complicated maybe for you if you forget about complex number, but I will remind all things to you about complex number again that we use for these topics. Here, if we have complex conjugate root, you know this minus plus says to us it is conjugate. Minus plus, and this is I complex part, imaginary part, the coefficient of imaginary part b, and the real part that is without I, okay, without I is a. So if we have like that, format again c1 exponential c2 exponential, but c1 exponential real part, additionally here we will put sine and cosine. Sine and cosine will come from complex parts, okay. Here complex part is b, always you will take is positive, so c1 exponential real part, sine imaginary part, c2 exponential real part, cosine imaginary part. Here maybe you will use cosine first one, it doesn't matter for us, you can use. For example, let's say this is our roots 2 minus plus I. What is a? A is real part, that is without I. This is 2. B is the coefficient of I, but take it positive. Coefficient of minus plus 5, but take it positive. That's why 5. B always will be given as positive number, okay? Not necessary to take minus 5. So y will be c1 exponential ax 2x sine bx, b is 5, 5x. C2 exponential ax, exponential 2x, cosine bx, that is cosine 5x. You will write like that. But what's the meaning of 2 minus plus 5i? How you will find complex number in mathematics? We know that in real numbers, the inside of square root cannot be negative. We always say if it is negative, there is no root. No, normally we have roots, but this is not real number. If we have negative part in square root, it means complex number. To define negativity in square root, the mathematician defined complex number. That's why here, for example, square root of 16. What is square root of 16? I feel good if I remind you about complex number. Maybe you know, and please forgive me if it is quite long. Okay, what is square root of 16 equal? 4. What is square root of 49? It's 7. We know this, but think that what is square root of minus 16? Close that minus. What is square root of 16? This is 4. Because of negativity in the square root, we will say 4i. Because I in mathematics square root of minus 1. That is negativity comes from this I. Close this part, okay? Minus 16, square root of 16 equal 4 because of this minus, this is I. For example, minus square root of minus 81. Close this minus, 81 is 9. Square root of 81, 9. Because of minus in the square, this is I, that is complex number. This is first things that you have to write. Complex number, you will understand this is complex. Why? Because of negativity in square root. What else? If we have r square minus 4 equals 0, what is r? Put minus 4 to the other side, r square 4, which number have like square equal 4? R minus plus 2, okay? If r square 9, r minus plus 3. If r square is 16, r equal minus plus 4. But if we have like that, r square plus 4 equals 0, send 4 to the other side, r equal minus 4. But what we say, if we have even power, the result cannot be negative. Here the result even power, result negative, means this is complex number. Close minus here, close that minus here. What is r? Close r square equal 4, r equal minus plus 2. We close. Because of negativity in square, we have to put complex number. Because of this minus, put I, that is complex number. This is important. In mathematics, you have to see complex number in this type expression. This is of course huge topic, but in this topic we will use this information. That's why this is so important for us. I hope you understand properly. If you know, please forgive me because I want to explain to you again. Okay, here. This is high order homogeneous because right side zero and the coefficient constant. Let's use auxiliary equation. R square minus 2R minus 5 equals 0. Don't be confused. Instead of y, we are writing 1. So use product rule, some product rule. Can you find directly two numbers multiplication minus 5 and addition, their summation minus 2? You cannot find. Let's use discriminant rule. What is discriminant rule? We learned in the previous video. Here, A is the coefficient of R square 1. B equal minus 2. C equal minus 5 for the discriminant method. What is discriminant? B square minus 4AC, B square minus 2 square 4, minus 4 times 1 times, this is, let's do this plus 5, sorry about that, plus 5, and this is 5. Okay, I did it plus 5. And 4, this is minus 20, and discriminant minus 16. Discriminant minus 16. I did it plus 5. Okay, minus 16. So let's continue. What is R1? We know that minus B R1 2 minus B minus plus square root of discriminant over 2A. This is the rule. I wrote together because what's the difference? Difference just minus plus here. So minus B, B is minus 2 will be plus 2 minus plus square root of discriminant. What is discriminant? Minus 16. Over 2a, 2 times a is 1, 2. Continue, 2 minus plus. What is discriminant here? Minus 16. Square root of minus 16, close minus. Square root of 16 equal 4. Because of negativity, minus in square root, put I. That's why this is complex number. If discriminant less than 0, what we say the result rules is complex number over 2. So divide 2 over 2 is 1, minus plus 4 over 2 equal 2i. This is the common mistake that I am seeing always. So 2 over 2, 1, minus plus 4i. No, this is wrong. Be careful about that. This is addition, subtraction, and you have to divide for each part by 2. Okay, so what is, for the roots, what is a? A is the real part, that is without I is 1. B is the imaginary part, that is coefficient of I, but take it positive, coefficient of I, 2. So what is result? Here, C1, exponential A. A here, 1, 1x, x, sine bx, b is 2. C2, exponential ax, a is 1, 1x, cosine bx, b is 2, 2x, and we found solution if we have complex number. You see, we use discriminant method to solve this problem. Here, auxiliary equation, r cubed plus 9r equals 0. So r is common factor, r square plus 9 equals 0. Here, let's solve. This is r equals 0. This is easy. But here, r square plus 9 equals 0. So let's solve this problem. R square equal minus 9. What we have? Square is negative. That's why this is complex. Close minus. R equal minus plus 3. R square. If R square equal 9, R equal minus plus 3. Because of negativity in square, this is complex. That's why I put I. This is normal root. This is complex root. For complex root, let's write what is AB, because I will use AB for the formula. What is A? A is the real part for us, that is without I. Are there any real part here? Without I, there is no real part, that's why A equals 0. What is B? B is the coefficient of I, that is positive. You must take it positive. Coefficient of I is 3, that's why B is 3. There is no real part, that's why A is 0. Let's write Y equal C1. What is the normally method? Method say C1 exponential, C2 exponential, C3 exponential. But if we have complex, we have to add sine and cosine. Here, this is not complex, normal number, normal root. So, C, real number, That's why C1 exponential 0x. Plus, normally we continue C2, but this is complex. So for that part, you have to apply complex formula, solution for complex formula. C, normally C1, but we are using in order C1, C2, C3. C2, this is complex, let's start. Exponential AX, A0, exponential 0x, sine 3x, plus continue C1, C2, C3, exponential here, exponential AX, exponential 0x, cosine BX, cosine 3x. We know that exponential 0 is 1, y equals C1, C2, sine 3x, C3, cosine 3x. All exponential 0 equal 1. So this is our result. And in this video, we learn how we write the solution of differential equation if auxiliary equation have complex conjugate roots. In the next video, I will solve more complicated question about auxiliary equation.